Davis on that front row. Jamie Ward, Cody Thompson on the second row. Jeremy Howard in the 3-10. The 11 be a Dean Boyd. And the 3, Austin Neely. So your most recent feature winner, need to get the move, move the kids away from the fence, please. Need to move the kids away from the fence, please. Stewart Davis on that front row. Witt Thompson in the second row. Howard and Boyd in the third row. Austin Neely all on his own in the fourth row, looking for green, this time by Heat Race 1, 10 laps. Here we go. Machine comes up second. Your points leader, the 88 of Brad Davis, finishes second. And put your hands together for your heat race winner, most recent winner in our Super Stocks, the 119 of Eddie Stewart. All right, on that front row will be the 460, Robbie Perkins, alongside the 43 of Bartley Grant. Second row will be the 360C of James Crow alongside the C5 of Daniel Carpenter. And on that third and final row, it'll be the 93 of Derek Bottoms alongside the 3 of John Cole. So we do not have any laps in the books. So Luke Sharp able to join the rear of the field. Perkins and Grant on the front row looking for a good clean start this time by. Thank you. heat race. Coming in third out of Hazard, Kentucky, the 360C of James Crow. Coming in second out of Berea, Kentucky, the 43 of Bartley Grant. And let's hear a four-year winner heat race number two. Coming to us out of Easel, Kentucky, the 460 of Robbie Perkins. So Hounshell and Adams on the front row, Mays and Kings on the second row. In the third row will be Barrett and Robinson. Third 10-lap heat race, looking for a good clean start. All right, need to get our youngsters away from the fence. Need to get our youngsters away from the fence, please. Four cylinders, four bangers need to be getting ready for your feature. Four cylinder feature is up next. Your top three finishers in that heat race. Coming in third out of Rogersville, Tennessee, to 6M. Lose a right rear tire. Finish that lap. So Johnny King out of Kentucky will be credited with third. Glenn Hounshell put on a good show for second. And your winner out of Laurelville, Ohio, the 42A of Jamie Adams.
Thank you. Well, we're going to get even start by the cone now. Can everybody stay out of each other's way and out of the way? Let's at least get a lap in and see if we can get things going and rolling and stay under green. Kurt Owens out to the lead of the number 14, but right with him is the number 56 of Horton Ray out of Sneedville, Tennessee. Chandler, the number 88, running in third, but he's got heat from the number 5 of Gary Blanken. Blanken up high. And it looks like the OZ Camaro of John Cook is riding in fifth, and now we got a caution on lap number 3. Look like number 3 of Neely going in against the tire. They're coming off of turn 4, but able to get the car rolling again and stays out on the track. One to go from the flag stand. Kurt Owens in the black number 14 leading them through. The number 56 of Horton riding in second place. Chandler is third, and here is the green flag. Gary Blanken coming up on Chandler, now dipping out on the inside, trying to make a move on him, nothing doing, has to tip back in the fourth. Kurt Owens still leads, but now here comes Horton on the inside. Flag next time by. We're going to go from the flag stand. Kurt Owens leads him off of turn 2 as he'll come back around for the green flag and a restart by the cone. Caution on lap number 11. And it looks like a tough break for Caleb Trent. Trent in the number 3 Camaro has got himself flipped around the wrong direction. high in the middle groove there in turn two. So we'll get him turned back around if his car is running. Green flag racing, Kurt Owens still leading them around, and now it's the number five of Gary Blanken. He's racing door to door. Tony Horton in the 56 trying to take number two, the number two spot away from Horton. Caution over in turn two. Caution once again. And it looked like the number 18 got tangled up. Off of turn four, Kurt Owens hanging onto that lead as best he can. But boy, he's got some strong contenders behind him. Gary Blanken, Tony Horton, the number 88 of Chandler. We've got John Cook in that yellow Camaro, and he's trying to hold off. I believe that's a number 33. That's the 31 of Willie Bessler makes the pass on John Cook. Race leaders now coming up into lap traffic. Kurt Owens still a commanding lead into number 14 as he brings the race leaders over into 1 and 2, now contending with lap traffic. Caution! We've got one flipped over in turn two. That would be the number four car. Lap number 18, Kurt Owens still in the lead, number 14. Tony Horton in the number 56 right there in second place. Then it's Gary Blanken is in third. And the white flag comes out signifying the final lap of the race. So Kurt Owens will finish in first. Tony Horton takes second place. Gary Blanken is third. So it's Owens, Horton, and Blanken. So congratulations, Kurt Owens in the number 14 as he takes home the chicken flag tonight. Tony Horton out of Sneedville, Tennessee, grabbing the number two spot in the number 56. Gary Blanken finishes third.
points leader, Brad Davis, on the front row. Locks out of 42, Jamie Adams. Second row will be the 460, Rob Perkins. Locks out of the 119 of Eddie Stewart. Third row is the 43 of Bartley Grant. Locks out of 20 of Glenn Hounshell. Fourth row is the 1 of Jamie Winter. Locks out of the 360 of James Crow. Next row back will be the 13 of Johnny King. Locks out of the 38 of Cody Thompson. Next row back will be the 3 of John Cole, alongside the 57 of Chad Barrett. Sixth row back will be the 310 of Jeremy Howard, alongside the 93 of Derek Bottoms. So we're going to try to get to 93 of Derek Bottoms, get him pushed off the front straightaway. So Brad Davis, Jamie Adams on that front row. Kentucky and Ohio, or Tennessee and Ohio on the front row. Kentucky drivers in the second row, the 460. Robbie Perkins out of Easdale, Kentucky. And Glenn Hounshell out of Manchester, Kentucky. Here we go, 25 lap Tri-State Challenge. Brad Davis, Jamie Adams, bringing him to green. Here we go. So we got everybody lined back up. Eddie Stewart, your leader, trying to pick up his third win of the season. He won last weekend. Jamie Adams in second. Brad Davis third. James Crow in fourth. Glenn Hounshell, current top five. So four laps in the books, 21 more to go. Flagman Bruce Keeler gives the field the one to go signal. Looking for green. Next time by. So Glenn Hauschel gets a little help spinning over in turn number two. Johnny King also involved with that, along with the 57 and Chad Barrett. Tracks through the United States. If you do get out of your car, unless it is on fire, you are disqualified for the rest of the night. So a safety rule there. So Glenn Hauschel, even though he's upset, got out of the car, and his night is over. Field gets to one to go signal. Eddie Stewart, your leader. Jamie Adams, second. Brad Davis, third. Barley Grant now in fourth. Jamie Witt holding on to the fifth spot. Four laps down, 21 more to go. Tough break for Eddie Stewart. Had a commanding lead over Brad Davis. Spins on his own over in turn number four. Coming out from the rear of the 88 car. Looks like he's okay for the moment. But a tough break for Eddie Stewart. Was trying to pick up his third win of the season. Also under that caution, you can see your heavy right side. So Brad Davis, who inherited the lead, he goes pit side. You can see he loves some fluid there on the front stretch. So a bad break for Brad Davis, who is looking for his third win of the season and trying to pick up the win at his home track. Only Eddie Stewart, but Brad Davis will back to green. Caution comes out for the black flag for Luke Sharp as he was told off the race leader not to come onto the track. So again, Luke Sharp was told across the race leader not to come onto the track. And he is black flag and he will park at 40. Evenly in second, Johnny King third. Eddie Stewart, who was your race leader. So bad luck strikes again. Bartley Grand was your leader. He slows over in turn number two after giving the lead away to Jamie Witt. And just before that caution was being thrown, Eddie Stewart was side by side. Gets one to go, 17 down, 8 more to go. Jamie Witt trying to pick up the big win. Eddie Stewart right there in second. He'd like to have that lead back. Lead from Jamie Witt. Cody Thompson spins on his own over in turn number two. to contact the front wall on the front stretch, leaving fluid everywhere. Classics, you're up next. Eddie Stewart pulls in, thinking he may be out of fuel after spinning out leading, going to the rear, working his way back up into the lead. Eddie Stewart pulls in as the field comes to the green white checker.
Virginia, Jamie Witt.
We'll put your name on a minute. Hold that.
Thank you. And my friend, they say it's never over till it's over. You was just glad to get that thing over with. Of course, you were running in the top five, had a good running. Stewart went to the rear, worked his way back past you, and under that caution, ran out of gas. But the main thing is, good to have you back. Victory Lane here at Tassel Speedway, Jamie. Picking up the $1,000.
I have to tell you, on that last restart, you know, Eddie was in front of me, and I said, Lord, if it be your will, let me win tonight. Guess what? I won.
There you go.
Hey there, Brad.
And gets congratulations to Brad Davis there. But your car is always quicker. But Eddie had the car to beat tonight, but this Iron Horse race car is always tough.
I tell you what, you got to finish to win it, and that's what we've done. Mine was missing and going on. I didn't think I could finish either, but, you know, I work in the garage a lot on this thing and do a lot of maintenance. It pays off.
It pays off. Be a sweet ride back to Wise Virginia, that $1,000 in your back pocket.
I needed that. I sure did. And, you know, it's just a pleasure to win here at Tassel. All these guys are really good down here. I'd like to thank my sponsors, B&D, Repair, Iron Horse Race Cars. I mean, that's so car with. It come off that corner, and I said, man, I can't believe how this car's hooking tonight. So we had a little bite in it and was able to bring it down.
Able to bring it out. Folks, it's here for your winner tonight, Jamie Witt.